Jim Pittman with head basketball coach here at Adelphi, David Duke. 97-90 victory for the Panthers against the Lightning of Goldey Beacom. You know, from a spectator standpoint, it was a very enjoyable game. I'm sure as a coach, it was a nail-biter.
We knew they were a very good team. What's really ironic is this was a mirror image of last year's game. We jumped out on them early. They came back, and then 97-90 is nothing. Last year, it was like 113-112.
Yeah.
112-111. It was they're an excellent team. They could really score the ball. They do a great job of making you turn the ball over. A little disappointed. We had 11 turnovers in the first half, 9 in the second half. They make teams turn the ball over on a quarter of their possessions statistically. I thought we could have handled the pressure a little bit better and gone out for some easy baskets. I was very pleased with the resilience. Sometimes when you get up a lot of points, you almost play not to lose,
right,
rather than to win the game. And I thought our guys did a good job late of making sure they kept their poise and made the plays that we needed to do to win the ball game.
Yeah, you had some great veteran leadership in the second half. Jack Laffey played well. The charge by Connor McGinnis. I mean, to me, I said it was the play of the game. You know, their best player, Tate's going to the basket again.
Again.
He had 36 again. Points. And Connor, smart enough, steps in and took a charge during crunch time.
He's a warrior. You know, three-year starter for us. Yes. He's excellent. He had when it comes to crunch time, we know Connor's always going to step up for us. Oz made some big foul shots for us, and then Connor made some big foul shots for us as well. That was a huge play, that charge. Those are the plays. Those energy plays are what win you games. Defending, rebounding, whether it's a charge, getting up on the glass. Those are the plays that win you ball games. A lot of times people think just the threes and getting out and making shots. And that right there is a great example of you make that hustle play on the defensive end of the ball, and it pays huge dividends.
A freshman really stepped up tonight. Dejavon Utley.
He's a great player. He's a great scorer. He's a true freshman, not a redshirt or a prep school freshman. And he's still learning. Mm-hmm. He is so gifted on the offensive side of the ball, and we're just getting better, you know, day-to-day, possession, on the defensive end. But he's a great player. He's a great young man, as nice of a kid as you can be. And he works very hard, and I was so pleased. He had struggled shooting the ball a little bit in the last game, but very pleased to see him come back, keep working, and keep attacking the way he did tonight.
I mentioned this the last time we spoke. You're not afraid to play the new guys. You know, a lot of times I noticed you might have kept one or two veterans on the court with them, but you're giving them plenty of experience here early in the season.
We have very talented freshmen, and our junior college guy, they're very talented. And we know for us to get to the level that we want to be, these guys are going to have to be able to go out there, whatever the level of the game is, whatever the score, whether we're down 5, up 20, whatever it is, these guys have to be ready to get out there and produce. And we're very confident in them. They're very talented. They work very hard, and we're going to play them.
You go back to conference play now. You go up to New Haven to play the Owls of Southern Connecticut. They always have a lot of firepower.
Terrific. Everybody in our league is terrific. So, you know, they're excellent. They're excellent at home. They're a very talented team. Scott does a great job coaching them. We're going to watch some film tomorrow. I want to go over some things on the defensive end. We came out to a great start on the defensive side of the ball.
Yes, you did.
And then they got it going, and I felt like our defense got a little bit porous, and they were able to drive a little bit. But we're going to get back to work. And Southern Connecticut, they're an excellent team, but we're going to start preparing for them tomorrow. I told you after during our interview on Sunday,
yes,
Corey Tate is an excellent player.
Yes.
You know, Livingston and Tate, tremendous. And he's a fantastic player. And as this was going on, as I was walking upstairs, I want to say I told you so.
Oh, but, don't doubt it.
He was fantastic.
After we spoke, I did a little research. And, you know, you're absolutely right. He was a terrific player. I think he's going to be playing overseas next year after he graduates. And, yeah, you know, he almost brought him back single-handedly with that 36-point. But, again, that charge by Connor McGinnis.
Great. So proud of Connor for that. And that's what we keep trying to get across to the new guys.
Right.
This is at the college level. You know, this is what you need to be able to do. Step, nowhere to be, nowhere to slide in, no one to take that charge.
Right.
Because that right there can be a game changer.
Now, that looked like a senior play.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, before you get ready for Southern Connecticut, you should enjoy this win because it was a great win. And Delphi again with the victory, 97-90 against Goldey Beacom. Jim Pittman with Coach David Duke. You've been watching AU Panthers TV on NE10 now.